7 years in gold.
That's pretty good, though.
This time? Right now, or when we saw it? You see? Just a... Tell me about it. And you got plenty of memory, so... See, that, the thing of it is that's curved. I think that's why it throws you off. You don't think so?
It's harder to see.
I kept swinging with it back and forth, back and forth. I just never did get it where... See, that don't look right.
Yeah, that looks
like that one. It does? Maybe it is because that's hanging down slightly or something. I don't know.
Thank you.
to look bad for me on this one.
Welcome to the Bryan Collegiate High School commencement exercise for the class of 2015.
Before we begin, I would like to remind you to please silence your cell phones and please be courteous and do not use air horn
as it is a distraction to our guests. I would also like to share that the content of and any views expressed during the ceremony.
Please rise as Bryan High School Junior ROTC posts the colors.
Color guard, stand, put. Gary, colors. Forward, put. Color guard,
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rang loud, the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Now please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, order.
Please remain standing for the invocation.
Please join with me in prayer. Father, thank you so much for our time here together tonight, for all the friendships we have made throughout the years, for all the days of laughter and fun we have shared, for all the times of great discovery and learning we have encountered, and for all the trials we have faced and come out triumphant in the end. Father, we are grateful for all who have given their time, energy, and skill so that we could graduate tonight. Thank you for all the family members, teachers, and mentors you have placed in our lives who have supported us through the years. May you bless them in the years to come. As we begin a new chapter in our lives, we pray for strength, pushing us on in perseverance and the drive to never give up. For faith, reminding us to always follow our dreams, no matter how impossible they seem. And for hope, giving us a reason to continually look forward to what tomorrow will bring. Thank you for our time together tonight and for all that we have to look forward to. It is in your name we pray. Amen. You may now be seated. Please join me in welcoming our principal, Christina Richardson.
I'm Christina Richardson, and I've had the honor of serving as principal of Bryan Collegiate for the past 8 years. I have watched all of you grow and mature into young adults, and I am so proud of all that you have accomplished. Tonight is the representation of your accomplishments. You have earned a combined total of over 2,500 college credit hours, with an average of 43 college credit hours each. Between all of you, You have earned well over 100 college acceptances. You have earned in excess of $2.5 million of grants and scholarships over the next 4 years, and you have earned over 10,000 community service hours. Many of you are the first to go to college in your families, and some of you are even the first to graduate high school. Congratulations on these amazing feats. I will begin with the introduction of our stage guest. Please hold all applause until we are done with all introductions. Please stand when I call your name. Dr. Thomas Wallace, Superintendent. Dr. Timothy Roki, Deputy Superintendent. Dr. Teresa Voltz, Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction. Barbara Ibarra, Assistant Superintendent of Student Services and Accountability. Amy Draws, Assistant Superintendent of Business Services. Mr. Tommy Vasquez, Board Vice President. Ms. Felicia Benford, Board Secretary. Dana Bichuk, Name Announcer. Ms. Kelly Levy, Member. Mr. John Street, Member. Dr. Douglas Warnerberger, Member. Mrs. Sheila Homeyer, Counselor. Tommy Roberts, Dean of Students. Barclay Bell, Keynote Speaker. Dr. James Kroc, Assistant Provost for Undergraduate Studies at Texas A&M. Dr. Sylvia McMullen, President, Brazos County Campuses, Blinn College. Dr. Joe Kirkland, Vice President of Instruction, Blinn College. Dr. John Beaver, Dean of Educational Partnerships at Blinn College. Astrid Rodriguez, Senior Class Representative. Alejandro DeAnda, Senior Class Representative. Wendy Tirado, Valedictorian. Paola Arias, Senior Class Representative. Farhan Mahmoud, Senior Class Representative. Dante Laird, Senior Class President and Salutatorian. Raven Wallace, Senior Class Representative. Thank you. Let's give these very important people a round of applause. Now help me in welcoming the Senior Class President and Class of 2015 Salutatorian, Mr. Dante Laird.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2015. Tonight marks a point we've been working towards for the majority of our lives. This night is about more than just receiving a diploma. We are celebrating the 4 years that we've spent together as students and friends, watching and assisting each other in our collective and individual growth. Of course, we haven't had ordinary high school careers. From taking our first college classes in our freshman year to reminding each other to take our IDs off at Blinn, we've had a pretty odd high school experience. However, our high school experience wouldn't be collegiate without the people, teachers, and quirks our school offers. I think I speak for all of us as a class when I say that even if once upon a time we dislike the school, we've all grown to love it immensely. I feel as if I know everyone that I'll be graduating with today, whether they enrolled this year or in freshman year. However, I think that even more than that, I want to thank the teachers that have been with us over the years, whether they're present tonight or not. In my experience, everyone I've known at the school has been personally and academically assisted in a serious manner by the teachers at the school. They care for us and help us even when it isn't exactly convenient for them. They're the reason we're able to receive diplomas tonight. They have seen us run, walk, and sometimes crawl through these 4 years, and they've been wonderful enough to help us through them. We've been with them and them with us during this period of growth and learning, and I thank you all on behalf of the class of 2015. I would also like to dedicate thanks to the family and friends that have helped all of us through our high school careers. I wouldn't have made it through these 4 years without all the friends I've met and been touched by at Collegiate. And I cannot thank you all enough for being so absolutely amazing. I've seen my fellow classmates and friends break and put themselves back together, grow and regress and more. To the families here tonight, thank you so very much. Your presence here sets in stone what we as students and people already know. You are here for us, and you will always be in times of good or bad. In closing, I want to speak on what is next to come. I find it odd that people always let today pass without incident, because you will never be able to live enough. There will always be more to feel and more to experience. So I ask you from person to person today to simply let life overwhelm you. I especially ask this of my classmates. Let it overwhelm you at every possible chance. I know overwhelming may have a bad connotation, but it's such a strong feeling to be overwhelmed, to not know what the next step is, or to wonder what will happen next. And that's what life is about. It is about knowing what to do until you don't anymore. And then you change, you grow, and you continue. You persevere. Don't let life pass you by or escape you. This is it. Love, be reckless, grow, break, and live. Live life like you don't remember the stress of yesterday and never knew that tomorrow existed, and you will be all that you ever dreamed of being. Thank you. Now, will the top 10% please make your way to the stage?
On behalf of the senior class of 2015, on this date, June 5th, we have presented the school and the student body with new furniture to be used in the Bryan Collegiate Student Go Center.
This furniture will be a stylish yet very comfortable addition to the Go Center, which has given us various resources over the past 4 years and has been a central hub for the upperclassmen while they are on campus.
We are delighted to accept this class gift on behalf of the underclassmen and staff of Bryan Collegiate High School. We wish the senior class of 2015 the best of luck in your future endeavors.
You have left us with many memories that we will treasure forever in our hearts. Congratulations on your accomplishments, and thank you for this gift, which will be used proudly by our fellow Panthers for many years to come.
At this time, we will recognize those students who are in the top 10% of their graduating class and the class of 2015 honor graduates. If you are an honor graduate, please stand at this moment and be recognized. The class of 2015 top 10% students are Dietria Evelyn Charisse Bowser. Dietria will attend the University of North Texas this fall, and she has a 4.3269 grade point average. Shelby Lamar Fisher. Shelby will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.3968 average. David Edward Capps. David will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.4371 average. Sonia Pratt. Sonia will attend Brigham Young University this fall with a 4.5364 average. Dante Jordan Laird. Dante will attend Stanford University this fall with a 4.6304 average. And the class of 2015 valedictorian, Miss Wendy Tirado. Wendy will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.8293 average.
Good evening, parents, teachers, honored guests, family, friends, and my classmates, who along with me have made it to this day after a long and difficult journey. I especially want to welcome the Bryan Collegiate graduating class of 2015. I am greatly honored to stand here as valedictorian and speak on behalf of our class. Surprisingly, this day has come much faster than any of us thought possible. It seems like we just began our countdown to the last day of class yesterday, but unknowingly, we are already here about to cross the stage and mark the end of high school. In our time here at Collegiate, we have made many friends and experienced many things that we'll remember and cherish. As a class, we worked hard to help our community, as we did when we all joined together to help the Brazos Valley Food Bank to package boxes of food. That is one of our best moments, where we exceeded expectations and managed to load many more boxes than we thought possible. As much as we worked hard, we also had fun by taking trips to prospective colleges like Texas State and San Marcos, where we were surprised at the layout of the campus, as it seemed to be composed entirely of outdoor stairs. That day, we learned about the college while getting a full walking tour that gave us a workout we will never forget. Although it may not feel like 4 years have passed since we first stepped on the BCHS campus, they have indeed passed, bringing a drastic change to each and every one of us. We may not see it, but if we remember as early as Panther Camp, our introduction to Collegiate, we saw the then senior class, who seemed so far away from us in terms of appearance and maturity. In my mind, they were like adults and we were like children. If we think about it, we are now in their position, looking the part of adults while feeling like we haven't changed a bit. Changes we have undergone, though, include physical change. Some of us grew really tall. But the most important change we went through is discovering that it is possible to be successful, that we can do it, and that we are here today because of that. One of the things I want to mention is the realization most of us must have made at some point in our life or our high school career, that point where you know what you want to do and why it means so much to you. I personally came to that point around the time I was just beginning my high school journey, where I knew what I wanted to do and why. I decided that I would do everything I could to become somebody that could change the lives of those around me for the better. I wanted to help my parents and give back to them for all they have sacrificed for me. It became my goal that I worked for relentlessly, pushing through the challenges that I met, reminding myself constantly why I was working so hard when I got tough, and becoming closer and closer as I neared graduation. As soon-to-be graduates from Bryan Collegiate, we can say that we feel prepared for not just college, but for life and the challenges that come with it. We managed to pull through a rigorous program like Collegiate and learn to really fight, as somebody told me, to make our dreams possible. And of course, it would have been impossible without the support of our parents who helped us in any way possible. They were that voice that always told us to never give up and that reminded us why what we were doing is so important. Our generous PCC teachers, like Ms. Bichek and Ms. Carrion, who made sure we were on track and ready for anything. Our principal, Ms. Richardson, who made BCHS possible, and our dean, Mr. Roberts, who made sure BCHS is functional and who offer their full support and encouragement when it is needed. Our core subject teachers, who taught us more than just English or science, but really showed us our potential. Our blend professors, who treated us like college students and offered us their wisdom. To everybody who in some way supported us or inspired us to do better, we extend our sincere gratitude. Without your support, we would not be here. Finally, as we take one more step forward, I just want to say congratulations, class of 2015. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Astra Rodriguez.
And I'm Alex DeAnda.
And we are so pleased to have all of you here with us tonight to help commemorate our accomplishments in finishing the first milestone of our lives.
Today we are honored to give a reflection speech of our class. This ceremony is more than just a celebration of our achievements and victories, but also a reminiscence of the past 4 years of that we spent here at Bryan Collegiate as we reflect back on them. I can remember watching a video about a collegiate, and I was told when we could receive up to 60 college credit hours, and it was all free. Though I had my priorities straight, I wanted to go to college. I still don't know what I was about to get into. Luckily, I had my best friend, Daniel, to fend off anything TV might prove of what being a freshman may be like in high school.
I can remember when I first received my acceptance letter from Collegiate, and I read the words, "Congratulations," written in the letter. It was at that moment that I knew I was about to enter a different world. Coming from a different district, College Station, I was worried about knowing no one and feeling alone. But once I actually entered the school, it was nothing like I would have expected. Upperclassmen greeted us at the doors and was even offered to sit with them at lunch. Of course, I was still nervous, but I didn't feel alone. I felt comfortable, and I was ready for the next 4 years of Collegiate.
However, all of our assumptions were diminished once we experienced Panther Camp, which successfully broke the ice between all of us. That is to say, those 2 days were a bit sweaty and a struggle, but exhilarating once our barriers were broken. We met new people and soon got to know each other better, and we knew this was the beginning of something great.
From the moment we started freshman year, we knew this school would change our lives forever. That is to say, who could forget our first PCC teacher, Ms. Colvin? Juggling the life of a high school instructor at Collegiate, teaching PCC and algebra in the morning with extracurricular activities in between, with also being a blend professor at night, to also tendering her family, she made it clear to us that time management is possible and the key in possessing a balanced life. Similarly, our English 1 teacher, Ms. George, taught us the importance of having punctuation and courtesy, not just in our essays, but in the way we communicated with each other as we settled in and soaked in the happiness of leaving at 1:25 on Fridays. Ms. George then later became in charge of a learning community called Student Ambassadors. In our junior year, she helped to teach us what being a leader is all about. She gave us the push that we needed in order to be successful. And even if you weren't an ambassador, she would still take the little time she had left to help you reach your goals and hear you out.
Finally, getting used to our crazy schedules and friends, we found ourselves in the good graces of Ms. Sanders in our sophomore year, teaching us the importance of how anything in the past may not only impact us today, but as well as ourselves. Back when we were first introduced to the idea of learning communities, Ms. Sanders was one of the first teachers to help make sure clubs go by smoothly. Having these school clubs not only helped gain friends, but also importantly, more importantly, taught us the different skills in possessing leadership and learning how to play soccer. For the most part, even though it was hectic having changes to our schedule, such as having 2 lunches and then the brilliant class, we still managed to take our friendships outside of the campus, but into those delicious JJ snow cones or the movies with no car. However, around that time, most of us were ending the year with permits, even licenses. That is to say, some of us were starting our junior year with stunning rides and some stunning slabs.
Being dropped off by the big magic school bus, it was obvious we were the newbies, or just young-looking college students at Blinn. Huddling together, trying to find our first class, some of us sitting in the wrong class, we still managed to pull off the conversation, "Oh yeah, I'm a freshman in college," or "I'm still an undecided major." However, some of us were caught red-handed wearing those Bryan Collegiate IDs that gave out our true identity to everyone at Blinn. Sometimes they felt as if we're a threat to them due to the fact that we're only juniors in high school taking their same courses. Fortunately, despite our roller coaster ride at Blinn, Mrs. Bichuk was always there to calm down our nerves and make things seem less stressful in our day. From helping to prepare us for the ACT and PSAT, to helping us write all of our college essays, Mrs. Bichuk always had the patience to hear everything, even our rants and jokes, and still, however, managed to make time for us, whether it was before or after school to help get our lives situated. We really thank you so much for that. It was teachers like her who impacted our lives every way possible.
With that being said, although some teachers moved from Collegiate with respects, there was one specific individual who loved us so dearly that he followed us all the way from our second semester freshman year all the way to our senior year. Geez, we even thought he might even want to come to us our blend classes. Barclay Bell was the teacher who really grew on us. He made biology, chemistry, and physics fun and comprehensible. That is to say, despite our jokes and complaints during class, he still managed to teach us in a way that we could understand. He knew what it was like dealing with our schedules and days for almost nearly 3 years. Mr. Bell is a big part of our lives, whether if it's in school learning about electric lights or at his wedding, seeing him at his happiest he's ever been. Mr. Bell taught us what the meaning of being a Bryan Collegiate student is by saying, At Bryan Collegiate, we don't give you the answer. You earn it. Meaning our school possesses a unique quality and we are privileged to have, that is the ability to think for ourselves in any given situation. Not only are we receiving a quality education, but we're also given the tools to find answers to questions we have throughout our lives.
Striving to become seniors, we quickly realized time has passed by really fast, taking the time in summer to reminisce our memories from freshman year to junior year. It soon hit us that we are becoming full-time blend students. With the help of Mr. Persine and Mrs. Gates, we were able to learn how to preserve a hard college math course with the help of math and science labs. As our fall semester ended together, we quickly realized that we needed to make every minute count that we had together because graduation was months away. Luckily, with the help from the gods, we were blessed to have Miss Carrion, our PCC goddess. Her sweet and calming words made our lives less stressful and not as bad. We even tried making a slogan by saying, keep calm and carry on. Not to mention, we weren't the only ones with stress. We commemorate every Bryan Collegiate staff member in doing their part to help every one of us to mature into insightful yet thoughtful adults. It's crazy to think that we are here tonight already wearing our caps and gowns, ready to receive our diploma, when most of us are worried to walk the stage in fear of shedding a tear and reminiscing our lives here at Bryan Collegiate.
Lastly, I realized our class possessed a unique quality of being there for each other. No matter what background, race, or sex, or gender, we still treated each other like family. That is to say, we helped each other stay aboard on this courageous adventure, and luckily for the most of us, stuck it out and pulled through, and now we are sitting here ready to graduate. More importantly, just remember that we are family. This school helped us become who we are today, and now we are finally going to college and departing to start our own lives in the real world.
We are proud to say we completed this challenge, and we are now ready to take on the world.
I have the pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker for the evening. He is a great educator and has been a respected member of our faculty since he was a long-term substitute when you were all freshmen in biology. He has impacted many lives of the students that walk our halls. Many in the senior class requested that he speak tonight since he has been such a significant part of their time at BCHS. Please welcome Mr. Barclay Bell.
Good evening. To begin, I want to say that I am honored to be speaking here this evening. Parents and friends of the graduates, I humbly thank you for entrusting your sons and daughters, your legacies, with us at Bryan Collegiate. You are the real reason and driving force for each of these young adult successes. You were there from the beginning, and you will be with them always. So I'd like to start by giving you the first and highest honors here tonight. I feel especially attached to this class of fine youngsters for several reasons, the most obvious being that I had the privilege of teaching them for the last 4 years. My first year of teaching was their first year of high school, and this continued for 3 more years. We learned together and we grew together. Their success was my success. Their failure, I counted as my own. The mistakes I made as a rookie teacher their freshman year still kind of annoy me. But even so, the relationships that were forged then grew deeper and stronger every year. We've shared many memories, finding soap on the chairs in biology, catching things on fire in chemistry, swinging on bowling ball pendulums in physics, pushing Mrs. Beechuck into the San Marcos. It's been a blast, and I will treasure this chapter of my life dearly. Graduates, tonight you finish a new chapter as well. A high school diploma, especially from Bryan Collegiate, is a huge accomplishment, one that you should take great pride in, but also regard with proper sobriety. One of the most significant memories I had after graduating high school was walking along the Continental Divide in Colorado along a trail through the Rocky Mountains. The Continental Divide is an imaginary line that divides two watersheds. Rain on one side of that line will eventually flow into the Pacific, and on the other side will flow into the Atlantic. I was in awe that I could dump my water bottle on the left and supply the Pacific, and then on the right and supply the Atlantic. Carried away by the wonder of it all, I was later frustrated that I had no water for the rest of the hike. I'm embarrassed to admit it, but it's true. Many of you, after the celebrations have faded and the caps and gowns have been stowed away, will face a similar predicament. Many of you in the coming months and years will face decisions that will dramatically change the outcome of your life. Two, maybe more, roads that substantially diverge. Choice of friends, major, career, marriage, children, these are just a few of the forks in the road ahead. And as you start college or the military, you will continue this journey on a fresh page in a new chapter. Choices left and right are part of this life. These decisions make life an exciting adventure. As you carry these choices, or as you make these choices, there's only one word of advice that I want to impart to you. Carry the fire. Carrying the fire means holding on to goodness in a world that is often bleak and dark. It's not about being optimistic. You already know that as a teacher, I'm a straight shooter. I don't romanticize, and I attempt to make things seem better than they are. This world can be dark, cruel, and hellish. Many of you know that already. Oscar Gamble may have said it best. They don't think it'd be like it is, but it do. Some will explain away or justify evil. Others will sweep it under the rug. But I believe the best course is to acknowledge it and move on, carrying the fire. For me, this has been the only way to effectively cope with those moments in life that both roads seem particularly dark and ominous. One time in college, I was faced with the decision to tell the truth and lose my job, or continue to hide a reality that was not beneficial to myself or the organization I worked for. Thankfully, I chose the honesty route, but being fired created difficult circumstances, and it began the lowest and darkest period of my life. Throughout the whole ordeal, however, I carried the fire, holding on to the fact that goodness, specifically God's goodness to me, would carry me through it. So how does one exactly carry the fire? I have three suggestions to leave with you about how to carry the fire. Remember the past, don't go alone, and hold on to hope. First, remember the past. Reflect on where you've been and where you've come from. Honor those who have helped you. As I mentioned earlier, this auditorium is filled with people who have encouraged, nudged, pushed, and sometimes dragged you along the way. Be thankful and always reflect on how far you have come. I personally do this by journaling my thoughts often and reading past entries. It always encourages me to see how I've changed, how prayers have been answered, and how messy, enigmatic situations have been resolved. The second way we carry the fire is to not go alone. Choose the friends you will run with wisely and lean on them when you need it. An African proverb says, if you want to go fast, go alone, but if you want to go far, go together. We are designed to be in community and to work together. Just as small fires are easy to put out, so it is easier to lose sight of goodness when we are alone and isolated. Finally, we carry the fire by holding on to hope. Hope is not a fantasy of how we wish the world was, but the assumption and expectation that good will win in the end. I can guarantee that your life will not turn out how you think it will, but I can also guarantee that goodness finds a way. Even the weakest flame is bright in the dark hour. Remember that time I was fired for doing the right thing? Despite all of the darkness and depression that ensued, I probably would not have taught at Collegiate were it not for that fateful day. There's no way I could have known the happiness and joy that I would have teaching and getting to know you all at the time, but I knew deep in my spirit that goodness would win, and I had hope, and I carried the fire. So this is it. This is your day. Celebrate your success and your hard work. Your parents, teachers, and friends have passed on a fire to you. Let that fire burn bright and keep it kindled. For when hard times come, you must remember this day and days like it to press on and to not lose hope. Remember your past, don't go alone, hold on to hope, and above all, carry the fire.
Dr. Wallace, I am pleased to present the Bryan Collegiate High School Class of 2015. The academic advisor and I have examined the records of these candidates, and we have found that each has completed the necessary requirements set forth by the Bryan Independent School District and are eligible to participate in these commencement exercises. Additionally, I am pleased to announce that we have six students who have completed the required course of study and are candidates for their associate's degree at Blinn College.
Thank you, Ms. Richardson. As superintendent of Bryan Independent School District, I certify that the assembled Bryan Collegiate High School class of 2015 is now eligible for their commencement exercises.
Thank you, Dr. Wallace. At this time, we will begin the presentation of diplomas.
Jesus Adolfo Alvarado Rodriguez. Paola Jasmine Arias. Janice Meredith Armagost. Marisa Natalie Armendariz. Alana Nicole Aviles. Sierra Brianne Ayala. Veronica Banuelos. Zachary Zylon Bogert. Dietria Evelyn Charisse Bowser. Alanis Sam Cantu. David Edward Capps. Yuridia Denise Cardoza. Christopher Guadalupe Castillo. Miguel Angel Cisneros. Cindy Yasmin Contreras. Angelica Leticia Corpus. Alicia Cruz. Margarita Renee Cruz. Daniel Edward Davidson. Yasbeth DiHaro. Alejandro Dianda. Oscar Alejandro Encinas. Daniel Escorza. Shelby Lamar Fisher. Maria Guadalupe Granados. Brennan David Johnson. Taylor Justin Jones. Joshua Stephen Kessler. Brooke Lauren Kincannon. Dante Jordan Laird. Farhan Mahmoud. Samuel Antonio Maldonado. Daniel Martinez. Veronica Martinez Tirado. Kayla Ivy May. Destiny Renee Medina. Matthew Medina. Taylor Renee Medina. Haley Mia Mendez. Brayton Robert Mendoza. Bertha Montañez. Cedrica Danae Newsom Green. Jessica Martina Norsworthy. Kristen Marie O'Neill. Jason Lee Paholke. Sierra Monique Perez. Tiffany Amber Ponce. Sonia Nicole Pratt. Michelle Azanet Quiroga. Edith Ramirez. Orlando Ramirez. Alondra Carolina Rodriguez. Astrid Maribel Rodriguez. Giovanni Rosas. Saul Josue Ruiz. Juan Tirado Sanchez. Maricel Cerrato. Richard James Soto Jr. Ashlyn Rose Street. Wendy Tirado. Rebecca Lynn Villapando. Osvaldo Villanueva. Candace Marie Wagner. Raven Camille Wallace. Megan Lucille Welch. Roxana Samaripa. Paloma Esmeralda Zaragoza Mendez.
Congratulations, class of 2015. Graduates, please stand and remain standing in your row. You forgot your tassel. At this time, switch your tassel.
I already did.